In the spaces where the light is streaming in through the peaked glass roof, a glow, a kind of spectral, dazzling shade that stands out in sharp relief against their shadowy neighbours. The light has been shining through the glass for hours, and the air is warm, getting even warmer. And yet, the tiles remain cold, and something about this disturbs me. So I raise my palm, touch it to them, spreading out my fingers and feeling the moisture against my skin, shivering slightly at the contrast of the cold beneath my palm and the hot air that swirls around me, closing in on me, causing sweat to start to seep through my clothes. Still touching the wall of tiles, I look to the side, noticing how the proportions of the tiles shift as they stretch out along the wall, continuing further than I can see. Hard to process parallelograms, receding into the far distance, shining white and sparkling. But when I look the other way, to my left, everything is shadowy and dark. I can't see where the tiles end there either. I'm suddenly gripped by this terrible feeling that I'm not able to turn around. I don't know what's behind me, and I'm not able to look and anchor myself. In the absence of being able to see, a chasm opens up behind me, and I press harder against the tiles to make sure I don't fall backwards and get swallowed up by the nothingness I know is there. I lean my whole body forward, closer and closer, until my head touches the slit tiles and I close my eyes, count slowly to 10.
Whilst it is the sacrificial body and blood of Christ, which is ingested in the ritualized feast of communion, in the Marquis de Sade's universe, it is shit which is rendered sacred by its ritualized consumption. Both acts, moreover, however mitigated by their varying concessions to literalism, are perverse, cannibalistic, and even coprophagic. Both ritualized meals, that is, the ingestion of Christ's flesh and blood, and the consumption of shit in Sade, are certainly abject ones, turning the ingestion of human waste into grotesque ceremonies. Of course, the process of transubstantiation in Christian discourse is another kind of alchemy. The low, dirty waste of Christ's body, substituted by the wafers and wine consumed in communion which act as simulacra of Christ's body and blood, is transformed by its stigmata into the purest, holiest, highest matter. The seemingly grotesque body of Christ, then, becomes effectively disembodied through this sublimatory logic. It is eerily transformed into something less than human. In Christianity, this disembodiment is an elevation of the base into the holy, and is thus perceived as clean, pure, and sacred rather than abject. Its wounds and waste are sublimated through the logic of sacrifice. In both Christian theology and the Sadean universe, the ingestion of bodily waste is attributed with alchemical, metamorphic, salvific properties which impart liberty and strength to those who understand its transforming power. The bodies of those who partake of the flesh of Christ are purified and transfigured by its holiness. Through the process of necrophagic ingestion enacted by communion, the bodies of the congregation are cleansed from sin, redeemed from baseness. The libertines inside prize excrement as a culinary delicacy and establish an elaborate bureaucracy to govern and refine its production and distribution. The libertines in 120 Days of Sodom place their victims on special diets to ensure the quality and flavor of their excrement. This scatological connoisseurship provides a precedent for trash, which prizes shit and garbage and constructs this aesthetic around the inversion and elevation of filth, waste, and lowness as valuable. The consumption of shit then in Sade, ingested willingly and with voluptuous pleasure by the libertine himself, who is transported by this scatological delicacy and inflicted tyrannically upon his victims, whose subservience and powerlessness is fortified further by the punishing act of enforced coprophagia, becomes a sign of the libertine pervert's own mastery and triumph over the law and over God, affirming and heightening his sovereignty. And in Sade, this figure is nearly always a he. Cannibalism, like coprophagia, also features on Sade's menu. In Sade, the body is subjected to a ritualized cycle of defilement. It is defiled not only through systematic sexual violation, but through its ingestion. At all points of violation, whether being fucked, tortured, or eaten, the body is excremental, a site of waste and a site for the satiation of appetite. For the libertines, the site of the human body exists to be consumed and savored, be it sexually, that is, the body's flesh, or digestively, the body's meat. And because eroticism inside is mechanical, inhuman, and stripped of the idea of free exchange, these roles are ultimately interchangeable. The body is thus at once both food and waste, or food and shit. Here, all flesh is on the verge of being transformed into meat at any moment. One must either eat or be eaten, and the process of fornication, ingestion, and defecation is a never-ending cycle of exploitation. In turn, in Christian theology, the consumption of the sacrificial body of Christ also represents the sacrificial ingestion of oneself, and also cannibalism. Because baptized Christians are seen to become flesh and bone of Christ's own, they themselves become the Eucharistic bread. The Eucharist thus represents a self-offering, a being eaten as well as an eating. The person who takes communion is at once food and eater, eating the body of Christ, and by eating, becoming that body. The congregation, which is of course also sometimes referred to as the body of Christ, therefore not only eats the waste of Christ's body, but also its own.